It's the NFL on EA Sports. And the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the 49ers and the Pack. And it's coming up next on Madden NFL 25.
This is such a special place. You drive through the streets of Green Bay, no tall buildings, quaint houses, and then boom, right there in the middle of the neighborhood is iconic Lambeau Field. Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis on hand. Kickoff just moments away. Charles, quickly, keys to the game.
For me, it's coaching. Who prepared his team the best going into this one to give them the confidence to believe that they would win the game? That's who's going to come out of this one on top.
Now the kicker, Brandon McManus, about ready to get us started. And off we go from Lambeau. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Well, the 49ers getting ready to go on offense, and it's the Pro Bowler Brock Purdy at the helm in his third NFL season now out of Iowa State.
And the great story of Brock Purdy continues. Had he been drafted in the first round, I think people would be singing his praises to the skies. But for whatever reason, people can't let go of the fact he's Mr. Irrelevant, and they don't give him the credit he deserves. He is not just a system quarterback. He's a guy who enhances his team. Not just along for the ride, he's the one steering the ship. And without him, their ceiling significantly drops.
Purdy going to the air right away. That's into the hands of the rookie from Florida. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? Some early fireworks on the first play from scrimmage.
The last fireworks I saw, July 4th, okay? Here they are celebrating the start of this game the exact same way. Explosive right out of the gate.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Purdy now to throw. Got a man right side. It's McCaffrey. Touchdown, 49ers. Christian McCaffrey, 39 yards. And the 49ers have taken the early lead on the road here at Lambeau. Well, if they didn't get the wake-up call before the game, they got it right now. Two plays already in the end zone.
I think of it in boxing terms because whether it's a big shot with your first one or a probing one, a little bit of a jab, the second one was the payoff. That was the big one that landed. 1-2, end zone.
Jake Moody now for the point after. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead. The long touchdown pass gets them 6 on a very, very tidy 2-play drive that time. So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. So the Packers make their way out for the first time, and it's Jordan Love that has the keys to the car here in his fifth season as a pro and second as a starter.
And I'll bet he's talking to his guys about resisting the temptation to try and turn this into an up-and-down game, almost like basketball, where both teams press and one team gets an advantage. Our team's trying to run with them, and they're just not equipped for it. Doesn't matter whether you're equipped or not. Just settle in. Get calm before you go for the big strikes.
Love going to break the huddle, lead the Packers up here first and 10 at their own 26. He'll buy some time right. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's second down.
Brandon, once that one broke down, there were only so many options left for him to take. Fortunately, only first down, so he smartly got the yardage he could get and didn't worry about trying to turn it into a bigger play and end up taking a bigger loss. Here, they hope they can regroup and get something different going here on second down.
Off the play fake, Love. He'll get this underneath to Jacobs. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot.
Bartney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot cool. of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster.
They go bootleg. Love. They swing that out wide to Jacobs. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. That's good for a first down, his second catch of the opening drive.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Our first carry for the All-Pro running back, it's Josh Jacobs. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. That's complete to Wicks. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. They clearly wanted to come out, Charles, and be aggressive throwing the football, and they've been pretty efficient along with that aggressiveness. He's now 4-4 on this opening drive.
Yeah, and that's led to a fresh set of downs. I like what he's doing back there. You can tell he's at ease, feels good about what he's doing. I think if I'm the play caller, I'm reading that, I'm continuing to let him throw the football.
And he'll get it inside the 35.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
Second and 7, operating from the 34. Love now. This is caught. It's Christian Watson. Touchdown, Packers! Christian Watson, 34 yards. And the Packers respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. They said that they wanted to get him involved early, and what a way to cap their opening drive, Charles. We know he's one of the fastest receivers in the NFL, and he showcased it on that play.
And when you have a guy like that, you want to make sure the defense sees him early, right? You want to see how they're going to adjust, how they're going to try and guard him, because they can't replicate his speed in practice unless they've got one of the few guys who are as fast as he is. And all it took was one drive, he burned them, and I don't think it's the last time they call his number in this one.
McManus's point after is good, and we are tied at 7. So that drive takes him down the field in 8 plays. And it was all capped off by a touchdown catch from Christian Watson. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. The Niners offense, led by their running back, headed out for the second possession. And he has been a big component of the passing game so far. You see the numbers for this first half. This defense is going to need to find some way to key in on him because he is eating him up right now. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles' defense. They were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's second and 18. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. Oh, what a move. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Here's Samuel. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time, because let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
What do they have for this? Third and 11. They go play action here. Purdy. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 43. A big third down pickup of 20 yards.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass on the first drive and comes right back, and he's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him, and I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked in for this one.
Throwing here, Purdy. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he is going to lose yardage here. 7-7, our score after one. The 49ers with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a second and 14 upcoming. Purdy will set up to throw it here. That's to the right side, complete to Kittle. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets them up for third down.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
Purdy sets up to throw again. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers' 27-yard line. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago, because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down.
This has been a good drive so far, and it's been a running game for the most part that's powered them down there. Another nice burst there, picking up a first down. Now it's first and 10, as you said, in the red zone.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Here's Purdy. That's over the middle and caught by Pearsall. And the 49ers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field, and just like that, they're going to be set up with a first and goal.
Purdy looking to throw. Touchdown! Ricky Pearsall. A 5-yard touchdown. And the 49ers have now taken the lead. Well, that's just how they drew it up, CD. His first read was there, got it to him quickly, and into the end zone.
Absolutely excellent execution by all involved. And the coordinator, got to give him credit, found the perfect play call. Quarterback let it fly as soon as the target came free, and his guy made a nice catch. Just how you draw it up in practice and then execute it in the game.
Now Moody for the PAT. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. A pretty long drive that time. 11 plays all told. And it's polished off by a touchdown for San Francisco. So here's Moody back out there now to send this one away. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. And what a return. Great field position all the way out to the 48 there.
At some point, we're going to get it through our heads. Special teams, special teams, special teams. The spark that often wins games.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did score their last time out, but they just had to watch that long, sustained drive, so we'll see if they can shake the rust off.
Yeah, and that's always a question that you have when you have to come off the bench after having sat there for a long time. Are you ready to go? Are you loosened up? But even more so, are you mentally alert and ready to put your best product out there?
To pass, here's Jordan Love. That's taken in by Watson. And he's taken down inside the 30. He had the touchdown on the opening drive. Now he's got a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Love. Quick throw, knocked away, and incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Here's second and 10. Love, they go play action now. Able to find his man, Kraft. And they'll have it in the red zone before it crosses over out of bounds. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
Another nice play there. They've gotten down into the red zone in no time at all. That's what this offense can do when they get on a roll. And now they're set up with a first and 10.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now Love. This is caught. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers. Romeo Doubs from 19 yards away. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. A nice connection there, finding his target, and that'll put six up on the board.
Just like they drew it up in their playbook and reiterated it on the sidelines, right? Perfect route, a good throw, and the defense, they had no answer for that right there.
Now McManus to tack on the extra point. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. So that drive spanned five plays. And that drive all capped off with a Romeo Doubs touchdown. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
Man, confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go-around. A big play there on the catch and run, 71 yards.
We talk so much about run after the catch, or rack, a term coined by our very own, the coach, John Madden, the legendary one himself. And you definitely won't find a better illustration of it than right here. He's going to take this one, and away he goes. Nearly takes it the length of the field before finally being tracked down.
Purdy. To the back of the end zone, but too high. Over everybody and incomplete. Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey. And he is going to lose yardage here. So they'll wind up losing 5 yards on the play, and that will lead to a third and goal.
Well, his completion percentage continues to rise with that one, but sometimes you watch your completion percentage to go down. Maybe you should have thought about throwing that one away.
I was just going to say, it is easier said than done, but that's where you maybe bury it at his feet, make sure he doesn't catch it.
Great call right there. Put it near the receiver, no grounding, nothing like that.
That's caught by Debo Samuel. Touchdown, San Francisco. A 9-yard touchdown there, and the 49ers have moved out in front. Well, just a sensational start for this offense, Charles. Three drives, three passing touchdowns.
Is that like mentioning a perfect game in baseball, or are we cool to do it here in football, partner?
No, I think you can do it here in football. I think perfect game in baseball, that's its own category.
Yeah, I think you're right about that. Could not imagine a worse start for that secondary. Or let's face it, a better one for this offense. No chance they stop passing now the way that it's going. I think they'll continue to press the ball downfield and hopefully reap the same results.
Moody good with the extra point. And the lead is now 21-14. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And it's Debo Samuel who caps things with a touchdown reception. So after the main field goal by Moody, he's back out to kick this one away. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. Charles, we'll see what they can do here. Not a ton of time left, but enough certainly to get points out of this drive, and they need them right now because they're trailing.
Yeah, this is exactly why you practice a two-minute drill all through camp and at least one practice each week before a game. A minute left, more than enough time to string a few completions together, reach the end zone, and then make that walk back to the locker room just a little more animated.
To throw now. Here's Love. And the Niners get there and bring him down. And the 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. An extra DB for the 49ers now on third. Jacobs going to try the middle. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now San Francisco going to call their second timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. On fourth down, the Packers call on Daniel Whelan to punt. Jacob Cowing deep to receive it. Oh, a heck of a move.
Man.
It's a 39-yard punt, 8 on the return, and the Niners will go on offense, 1st and 10.
The visitors' offense and their wide receiver getting set for this next possession. And seemingly every time they've looked his way in this first half, it has resulted in a big play, as borne out by the numbers.
The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And with great starting field position and one timeout in their pocket, they could still come away with points here in the late going. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Back to throw, Purdy. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash, this from 37. And his kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3.
The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. And out a little across the 25 to the 27. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And they're still very much in this game, although they do trail. What's the game plan, Charles, for the second half?
It might be a little counterintuitive because most people will think losing equals passing the ball more, but I'd establish the running game. They kind of went away from it in the first half. I think if they get back in balance, it'll help them when they put the ball back in the air.
Second and nine. Love looking to throw it. And down he goes. The 49ers get there. Malik Collins coming right up the gut. Gets in there for a loss of nine. And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Here's Love. Finds his receiver, Watson. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
There's another example what defensive coaches constantly preach, not allowing any run after the catch. They gave up a few more yards than they wanted to, but they were able to get him down quickly and force a fourth down.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. And here's a fair catch taken at about the 24-yard line. The 49ers offense and Brock Purdy getting ready for this next possession. And as we show you some of the highlights from earlier, he has been instrumental in getting his guys the lead as he looks to finish strong and close this one out. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. They have played so strongly. You look at the scoreboard, you probably, with the way they played, you would think the margin would be a lot bigger, right?
You would. And in your experience, how many times have we run into coaches where they've talked about, hey, we just want to put it in the hands of our defense and have them win the game? In this case,
yeah, not the case.
Not at all. You want to put it in the hands of your offense, but you always feel better about seeing defense because you think defense is a constant and offense kind of comes and goes. Today, this game, no, they need their offense to stay on a really hot level.
They've been hot so far. That's complete. It's Kyle Juszczyk.
Well, they've certainly spread the ball around so far, but they're definitely getting everyone involved now when you're throwing it to the fullback. Just shows how versatile this offense is and how everyone is a threat.
Here now, third and a yard. Now Purdy. Able to find the open man. That's complete. And he is going to have a 49ers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
McCaffrey running up the middle. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read,
he was able to make the play.
Purdy now to throw.
And that's complete to McCaffrey. So that'll go as a 4-yard loss on the play. And it'll be a third and about 13.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball, because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. That's caught by Jennings. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. They give him 27 yards on the third down conversion.
I'll tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available, because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them. And these guys have been taking advantage so far.
So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 32-yard line. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw.
That's complete to Pearsall.
So the completion good for just 3. And it'll be second down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well, because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
Throwing here, Purdy.
The tight end Kittle has it on the left side. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 17-yard line. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
Trying to get to the outside. This is McCaffrey. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Those are the plays this defense needs with the deficit they're facing.
It certainly is, and they've got to continue to swarm the football and hope that someone, while they're holding up the ball carrier, can get in there and rake it and lock it free. They need to get some takeaways as well.
Purdy off the play fake.
And he's got it. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Eric Saubert from 17 yards out.
And the Niners will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third. Boy, he has been fun to watch throwing the football in this one. It's certainly not fun for that defense, though, Charles. Now up to 4 touchdown passes in this ball game.
Yeah, we're supposed to be neutral, but I'm feeling their pain right now, because he has absolutely carved up this secondary. A clinic on how to attack a defense and take them out of the game.
Extra point try now for Moody.
And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. A 10-play drive that time. And the end result for the 49ers, a touchdown.
So following the touchdown, here's Moody back out to send it away. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get 2 more possessions.
Green Bay, Wisconsin is the spot. Third quarter inside Lambeau. Glad you're with us. Second and 10. They'll run right here with Jacobs. And he'll get about three here as he's out to the 30. Yeah, so they get that one, Charles, on the right tackle.
Yeah, oftentimes in that spot, you're trying to work against a defender, trying to set the edge in the running game, and you're trying to drive around and get your body twisted so that he can't get there. Sometimes your hands get too involved.
Gets it up around the 22 and no further. Did show some power on the run, but not a whole lot of room. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Love now. That's to Kraft, the tight end. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds. They'll get 11, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
On now is the Packers punter, as he's on here to punt it away. And he'll get credit for putting him inside the 20 as the fair catch is made right at about the 19-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offenses call four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20. McCaffrey on the counter. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up. Three quarters in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now at Lambeau. It's 49er football here. They've got the lead as well as we get set to start the fourth and final quarter. In motion left here, one of their tight ends. Play action. Now Purdy connects with Kittle underneath. And he's not going to sniff the first down here. He stopped at the 25. Short completion, just 4 yards. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down. And they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
O'Donnell, he's on to punt as he gets this one away. Fair catch signaled for and taken just shy of the 30-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Even though they were able to force the punt defensively, still a big hole to climb out of, especially at this late stage of the contest. No gain on the screen there at second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Now a second and 10. Love from the gun. On the out route, Dobbs brings it in. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down.
Well, those are the types of plays they probably wish they had made more of in the first three quarters. And this deficit is going to be tough to overcome here in the fourth. But a nice first down and a pickup on that throw.
Yeah, and this is where his coaches, you're looking for effort and execution, even though the scoreboard is going against you. You want to find out who's going to fight, who's going to scrap, and who's going to keep their heads up and continue to play.
Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down.
I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws.
And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
And not a common sight, at least on this drive. A momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Second and 10. Going back to Love. That's taken in by Watson. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's going to have a Packers first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on third and one.
Well, they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That's coverage you'd expect to see in a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
Here's second and 10 now from the 35. Working out of the gun. Love. Quick slant to Watson. And this will move the chains again as the tackle is going to be made at the 49ers 16. That, I believe, will put him over 100 yards receiving for the game. Yes, it will. And he's got a first down to boot. Throwing. Love. Completed out left to Dobbs. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agree. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Jacobs. Oh, he's going absolutely nowhere as he is hit behind the line. It's a loss of 4 on the first down play.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense was pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame woofing has turned into results.
2 of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to and they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line.
That is Nick Bosa from out on the edge who worked his way in for the sack.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. They've got it 3rd and goal now as they try to punch in a late touchdown. To pass, here's Jordan Love. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Isaac Yiadom picks it. And the Niners are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
Well, I mean, field goals probably aren't going to cut it at this point. This was touchdown or bust. And unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to force the issue here. Maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game. But give credit to this defense. They've really stood tall throughout. And they come up with the interception in the end zone.
The 49ers ready to set up shop again offensively.
And as we look back at how we got here, you'll notice a common theme in these highlights. A lot of yardage through the air. The passing game has been sharp right from the outset. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Now they are really in the driver's seat here, enjoying this lead late in the fourth quarter. The defense does have all three timeouts, but at this point, doesn't look like it's going to matter much. Brought down that time by Quay Walker.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
The stop for no gain brings up second and 10 from the 20. They'll try and burn some clock now with McCaffrey. And again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. Calling no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he's going to get this to about the 20, but that is well short of what he needed. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down.
As much as I praise teams for being true to who they are, in this situation, I wonder if maybe they outguessed themselves a little bit. Third down, seemed like an obvious passing situation. They chose to run it and didn't get anywhere close to a first down.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. So the victory here for San Francisco, and it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great way to close them out.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Lambeau.